When the pandemic started, my producer and I were doing a story every day, and it was completely pandemic related. We did not tackle any other subject but the pandemic. For months and months, I would say at least 2 months, we were doing pandemic stories every day. And so that metabolism was very different. That was hurry up, find something, do something, react to something. Very reactive or very instructive and very educational. That's we sort of switched our focus from investigations of big picture things to very, news you need, what you need to know, the questions you're asking, what do our viewers care about right now? And all they cared about was the pandemic. And that is still very top of mind. To do a story, to research a story during the pandemic, sitting, as you say, right here in this study, which is exactly what I did. Because of the internet and because of telephones and because of all the communications that we can do that's not face to face, I wasn't so different. The thing that was different was, I usually go places. I'm usually, in the file cabinets or in the offices or in someone's home or in someone's office or on the street with someone in person. And so doing things only via Zoom ne of necessity narrowed those kinds of experiences. But we were thankful every day for Zoom because everybody understands the technology. Everybody understands FaceTime and Zoom and whether you can do it by some other platform. It all works, and people are savvy with that and sanguine with that. And we did many interviews by Zoom. It's more difficult to do a confrontational interview by Zoom because, the person who you are confronting or asking a question of, or the person who is not happy to talk with you, it's very difficult to say, "Can I send you a Zoom invitation for 11 and then I'll talk to you on Zoom?" And they're like, "No." So I think that has changed considerably. The face-to-face discussion with someone who you may be doing a story about, who maybe doesn't want to be on TV, is not going to answer your Zoom invitation. And as a result of that, our stories had to be, the results of the stories had to be more based on what someone would tell you in a statement. There's much less opportunity to follow up with the question. And that's just how the world is. And that's just how it'll be until this is over.